is saying there's going to be an answer. There's going to be an answer. That amen is very powerful. I want a better amen. Thank you, Father. There's somebody here, I don't know what has been happening in your life. Leave us here. It seems as if your life is scattered. You can't really comprehend what is going on right now. You've tried, you know, all you could with your own strength, you know, and it seems as if you're not meeting up to that standard. I don't know what seems to hold you, but the Lord says today, upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Yes. And the house of Jacob shall possess the apostleship. There's somebody here, you are going home with your miracle.
Amen.
You are going home with package.
Amen.
You are going home with blessing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Pauline,
are you Pauline? Please come. Lord, you're worthy. I need to preach very late, but you just told me so. Just raise out your hand. Kalabashia. Thank you, Jesus. I'm seeing a man, a father, you know, a father. You will not lose your father.
Amen.
Oh, your amen is not working well. You will not lost your father. Whoever that is planning a satanic attack, he shall return back to sender.
Amen.
I said the love of your father, between you and your father. Love is so strong, there's this bond. But you will not lost him.
Amen.
I repeat again, you will not lost him.
Amen.
The hand of the enemy has been broken in your life.
Amen.
And in the life of your father. Somebody say,
Jesus,
we commit our Father unto your able hands. Protect him. Protect him. Just say, protect him. It is done.
Amen.
Can you give a round of applause unto the King of this one? Praise the Lord. Please sit, sit briefly. Sit briefly. Hallelujah. I want us to go straight to gospel briefly. I'm going to be taking you to some certain things in the Word of God. We'll pray, explain some scriptures, and we'll take some prayers. I want you to be provoked in the realm of the Spirit, because I believe that something is about to happen in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's turn our Bible to the book of 2 Samuel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, when the man of God was introducing me, he didn't say my surname. And I would like to put it, my surname is Olamide. So I will always want my surname, you know, to be mentioned. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's look at the book of 2 Samuel chapter 9. 2 Samuel chapter 9. I'll read from verse 1, then I'll stop at verses 5. Praise the Lord. 2 Samuel chapter 9. I'll read verses 1 and I'll stop at verse 5. The Bible says, and then he said, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul, that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? Verse 2. And there was of the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. And when they had called him unto King David, the king said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he said, thy servant is he. Verse 3. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul, that I may show the kindness of God, unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan has yet a son, which is laying on his feet. Verse 4. And the king said unto him, where is he? And Ziba said unto the king, behold, he is in the house of Masha, the son of Abimelech, in Lo Debar. Verse 5, the last verse. Then King David sent and fetched him out of the house of Masha, the son of Abimelech, from Lo Debar. Lift up your right hand above you and say, Father, touch me.
Bless me.
Father, touch me.
Bless me.
Okay, just hear this. Father, thank you for your word this evening. May I not be recognized. May I not be known. May that glory be seen and be recognized today. It is my anticipation that everyone be carried under your wind. Let your spirit take over this arena tonight. At the end of the day, your name alone shall be praised. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That amen is very weak.
Amen.
I want to speak on a subject that I titled, It is Time to Pray. Can you tell somebody next to you, say, it is time to pray? I think
you guys are used to elbow or handshakes in church, like the one I preached 2 weeks ago. Like, they use their hand to, like, some, the one I preached last, like, elbow, you know. Anyhow, tell the person, it is time to pray.
It is time to pray.
It is time to pray.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, we have read in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 9 verse 1 to 5, talks about a story, a very familiar story, but in that story there's something I want you to understand. The Bible says there come David the king. We knew how David was taken from zero to an hero. We knew how David was taken from the bush to the palace. But the Bible says a time came when David had no rest. David lost his sleep. David lost his rest. The music in the palace could not console King David. The wives in the palace could not console King David. Nothing could console King David, because God was getting ready to take somebody. Anytime God gets ready to take somebody, he suspends law. Anytime God gets ready to take a man to the next level, he breaks protocols. Anytime God gets ready to lift a man to the next level, he can do anything. God can be more position to lift a man. He can take life to lift a man. He can do anything to lift a man. I came to speak to somebody. After tonight's prayer, God will lift you up. I said, God will lift you up. I said, God will lift you up. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, and it said, is there yet any in the house of Saul? In other words, God is saying in this meeting, is there yet any here that needs my help?
And the answer is saying yes.
Every day is God's day, but the day you believe it comes your day. Every time is God's time, but the day you believe it comes your time. Every hour is God's hour, but the day you believe it comes your time. Today I provoke you in the realm of the spirit. You shall believe. Tell me, I shall believe. Stay alive, I shall believe. Stay alive, I shall believe. I shall believe. I shall believe. I shall believe. I shall believe.
The Bible says, is there anything that is left for the house of Saul?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Success is a school, but problem is a school fees.
For a man to get there, you must be prepared. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong.
In who? In who? No, no, no. I think it's me. Or your pastor.
Be strong. Oh my God. Can you say with all brothers? Be strong. And in the power.
Oh my God. Do we have strong men or women tonight?
The miracle is not in the beauty. Neither does the miracle is in the age. The miracle is what you carry. There's somebody here tonight.
You are about to get pregnant. And this pregnancy is a lot of prayer inside you.
And I keep telling you,
God knows power. Glory.
When we
glory.
Are pregnant.
Praise God.
Sometimes you don't understand how they feel.
Praise God.
When she gets to 4 months, her legs are broken. Week 5 months, her legs are broken. Week. But she keeps the pregnancy. But one good thing I want to understand, when she goes into a labor room, she's not coming out with one. She's coming out with two. She and the baby. I want to provoke you today. In this ministry, you are coming out with double.
Amen.
God will give you promotion.
Amen.
God will give you children.
Amen.
God will give you a man or a woman if you are not married.
Amen.
God will open doors.
Amen.
You will see mega doors.
Amen.
It's not going to be by work. It's not going to be by sweat. It's going to be by grace. Somebody say, I enter into my prayer room. 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 Without prayer, there is no direction. pressure. Without prayer, there's no breakthrough. Without prayer, there's no lifting. Without prayer, you can't get there. It takes a man to pray, and it takes God to understand. God is about to provoke somebody in the realm of the spirit to say, yes, I am getting it. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 30, verse 5, it says, weeping may tarry through the night, but joy comes in the morning. That joy that comes in the morning is prayer. I prophesy to somebody, as you pray tonight, you will see your joy. Can you tell somebody, I will see my joy? Say, I will see my joy. Say, I will see my joy. Say, I will see my joy. I will see my joy. Take your seat for a few minutes. Hallelujah. I wish to communicate. Hallelujah. The Bible says, he said, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul? Now, I may show him kindness. And the Bible said, there comes what? A servant called Ziba. Listen to me. See, people can mock you. People can laugh you. People can laugh at you. It is in the interest of every man to have something that they call weakness. But listen to me. It does not matter how many times they laugh at you. That doesn't matter how many times they mock you. They laugh at you because they don't know where God is taking you to.
Amen.
They mock you because they are not your creator. They say, oh, things against you, because when God is true with you, can you tell somebody, I'm in the process. When God is true with you, thank you, Jesus. And the Bible says, Ziba came and told King David, he said, no, this man you are about to bring is a Mephibosheth, he's a cripple. Is he lame on his feet? How can you bring him to the palace? Let me speak to you. You see, God is saying, if it's true, we have chairs. I'm not saying everybody has to be there. But listen to me, there are exclusive places God has designed for people at a time, at a certain time. And sometimes when God wants to do a miracle, he does not follow the crowd. Or follow the trend. God goes ahead to do any miracle he feels like doing. David wanted Mephibosheth to the palace, but they were obstacles. In the plan of God, everyone of you supposed to be greater than them. But in the realm of the spirit, there are people, because they saw their heart to Satan, they want to see how to bring you down. And that's what the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. For wrestle not against flesh and blood. It is not flesh and blood we fight. Beyond flesh and blood, there are principalities and powers. Beyond it, control the physical, not the spiritual. The Bible says it is the spiritual that controls. So if you are a failure in the realm of the spirit, right, you will become a failure in the physical. Any mother wants to be in charge must take possession in the realm of the spiritual. When God makes you something in the realm of the spiritual, it means in the realm of physical, you will become what he has made. Why Jesus defeats Satan? It was from the beginning in the realm of the spiritual.
That's right.
Before Jesus was born, there were revelations. Before Jesus was born, an angel came.
Amen.
You know, to tell Mary, this is what you'll be waiting for. This is what I'm waiting you. And when Jesus was born, you were three wise men. So Jesus once set up in the realm of the world spiritual. And so it was easy for him to penetrate successfully in the realm of physical. Beloved, if the enemy holds you in the realm of the spiritual, you have to break it. You have to break yourself out.
That's right.
So he says, is there any left in the house also saw, that I may show him kindness. And Ziba said, yes, there is. But this man has nothing to write to. Every problem we face through in life, every problem we face through in life, God knows. Not one thing in the realm of the spiritual, you can tell yourself, I am bigger than my problem. I am mightier than my problem. You cannot be bigger than your problem in the realm of the spiritual. It is in the spiritual realm. You manifest it. That's why the spiritual realm is not to be told with. It's not every man and woman that will understand you in the realm of the spirit. Because some persons, they fail to understand why you are here. Some people feel it's all about money, it's all about working, it's all about party, it's all about clubbing, it's all about one or two things. But you talk differently. Champions are not made in the realm of the physical. Champions are made in the realm of the spiritual. God will, you know, make people in the realm of the spiritual. And that was why when David grabbed that realm, where David was, never put him down. How can a man be subjected to an angle of failure? Where the parents never believed on David. Read your Bible. The parents gave David an assignment, and the assignment to do was disgusting. Take care of the sheep. And the Bible says in that bush, David, take care of the sheep. David will sit down and communicate to God. A man of understanding who hear and shall increase in learning. Say, well, only fools despise wisdom and counsel. David communicated to God. What is prayer? Prayer is an art of communication. You are communicating with God. Even when man seems to understand you, even when man seems to understand you, you don't care. You keep communicating to God because it's an art of communicating to God between you and God. That was why he came to a time that even the priest in the church could not understand. It does not matter how many men in your family. It does not matter where you are coming from. It does not matter sometimes if your wife or your husband or your children took you for granted because you pray, you fast. It does not matter because you know you can't get power from anywhere. The only power you can have from anywhere is the power of God. And that's what the Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter 91 verse 1. It said, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. He did not say he that dwells in another known place, but he said he that dwells in the secret place. What is God's secret place? The altar of God is God's secret place. You are here because you are in God's secret place. You are here to know what God wants for you. You are here to consult God. I want to prophesy to you that your consultation, you will see. David asked. Hallelujah. There's one thing I keep praying. I say, Father, may I not be in your presence and never receive. I want to receive you. Anytime I come to your presence, you know the future. You don't understand your future, but God does. In Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5, he said, Jeremiah, before you were born, I knew you. You cannot become a star until certain things in your life are rooted. Every man is coming from somewhere. Everyone here will all have a foundation. Nobody's from the sky. You can choose a woman. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just as our faces are different, also our need are also different. Your next level is somebody's prayer point. when an opportunity meets with an ability, there will be performance. Amen. What brings performance is when the people's hearts are open. Tonight, it is my prayer that the Lord will take your prayer.
Yeah.
You know, see, there are different ways to pray. But one major prayer is when you forgot yourself and you are lost in the house of God. And that's what that songwriter said. And now, I'm lost with. Hallelujah. We are always lost. If anybody has told you that there's going to be COVID, nobody will take it serious. God knew from the beginning. He understands the length of this head, the height of this head, the breadth. Is there any person? It is time to enter your prayer room.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says Mephibosheth had issues. But one thing that struck my heart most was the fact that Mephibosheth's father, Jonathan, was a close friend to David. And those things Jonathan was doing with or doing for David was very significant. Jonathan protected David from so many misfortunes out that before him through the father Saul. And the Bible says a time came. David was restless. Until your enemies become restless, you may not get to your end. For every man, there's a dream. For everybody, there's a dream. But it's not every man that sees their dream comes to accomplishment or comes to pass.
Yeah.
One of the richest places on earth is the graveyard. When you see dreams, we never aborted. That is when you see men that were bishop to rule, but you never ruled. That's when you see so many calibers of men who had everything to render to humanity. But wherever they are coming from, one or two paths of darkness brought them down. Sassy had a dream. But what wrote the dream done was denial. Prayer is a school. Prayer is what a school. The Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 1 verse 12, it says, for as many have received it in him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. To as many. It's 121 verse 2. Thank you, Jesus. I just see in the realm of the spirit that the Lord is about to organize some person's life.
Amen. Hallelujah.
There are destinies here tonight. And the Lord is about to, you know, change them. I keep telling men and women, it is not by labor, but it's by favor.
That's right.
There are so many men and women. If I want to rate you, your kind of job they do is not in comparison with the money they pay you. Your kind of job you do is not in comparison In other words, you work very hard, but at the end of the day, you are giving peanut to go with. Not until God settles some certain things in our life. You don't get there. You don't get there by physique. You don't get there by fashion. You don't get there by color. You don't get there by age. You don't get there by fatness or thinness. Mm. But you get there through prayer.
Right.
Prayer is God Himself.
That's right.
That is why you come to the house of God and you keep praying. Even when men refuse to understand what you are doing, you don't care. You get to a level of that, you know, a spiritual realm where you don't care. But you know you are praying. You don't care. You know you are talking to God. Esther never cared. In Esther chapter 2 verse 16, the Bible says that the king wore Esther the royal crown. Esther kept, you know, herself with God. Esther kept serving God. And her reward was the crown. I prophesy today, before now to the end of this year, your reward shall be God's blessing. Your amen is seeking. Your amen is not cutting. Your amen is not motivating. I said that your reward this year shall be blessed. Somebody say, my reward shall be great. Say, my reward this year from God shall be great. Somebody say, higher doors. Somebody say, higher doors. Somebody say, big doors. Somebody say, open doors. God wants to take you to a school of prayer. And this school of prayer is where you must, you create time. Those days in Africa, when I was coming, like when I was still in Algeria, when you talk about prayer, you see the church, you see the people wants to pray. But today, it's quite unfortunate that people no longer pray. They no longer come, say, let me tell you, I keep telling men and women, I will elaborate on it on Sunday more. But listen to me. You don't need the buyer and the seller sometimes in your life. You need the source. Mm-hmm. Buyer and seller may always come and go. Mm-hmm. But the source stands to the end. And the source is God. You can imagine. Every man and women, we dress differently, but with different clothes. Inasmuch you're wearing different color of dress, that is how we have different things in the market. It comes and goes. You see what I'm wearing right now? Some of you are not wearing what I'm wearing right now. Pastor and I, we're wearing the same, you know, native, they call it. But you are wearing English wear. Any of it comes and go.
Yeah.
But what stands is the source. So you come to that level where you say, Father, I don't care about the buyer and the seller. Teach me to speak to the source. Because the source owns the buyer and the seller.
Yes.
And the source is always here. He said, in my presence, in Psalm, there is fullness.
Amen.
Of joy. So, in the presence of God, there is fullness. It takes the grace of God to bring happiness. Money does not bring happiness. It is the presence of God that brings happiness. That's why you have so many rich men and rich women. They find happiness. No happiness. When it is divine, the supernatural exceeds the natural.
Yeah.
Anything that has to be done by God is a supernatural. Yeah. We don't need a natural, we need a supernatural. Because in the natural, men are bound to fail because it's natural. It's natural that people go to church, but they don't take whatever they hear from the altar. It is natural you force men to give to God. It is natural that you must walk before you eat. But the supernatural aspect comes into play through God. And that's what the Bible says. Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens. It did not say, I can do all things through the government. And I can do all things through my family members. No. But I can do all things through who? Through who? Christ. Through who? Christ. Through who? Christ. That what strengthens. It's a 121. Guess what? Said my head, I will look up to the hill. Where are you looking up to right now? Is he your family member or your friend? But I will look unto who? The hills. Where cometh what? In verse 2, my head cometh from who made? Who made? Who made? Love it. For you to enter into prayer, you must be ready. God loves people that are tough in the realm of the spirit. I'm not saying be violent, no. Tough in the realm of the spirit. There are prayer you pray, you feel it that God has answered.
Yes.
There are some prayer you pray, amen, you also know it's not carrying weight. We are in an era of two things in this world. One, we're in an era of command, and also we're also an era of demand. When you demand, you are pacific. Let me rephrase it. When you demand, you are not pacific. But when you command, you are pacific. Demand is optional. Demand is optional. But command, you are telling the person, this is my right. I command you to give me my right. I came to prophesy to some of you who the enemy has taken something from. I came to prophesy to some of you who the enemy has, you know, push you at one side. Every time you try to come up, the enemy try to pull you down back the way you are coming from. I prophesy tonight. I prophesy this morning. Wherever you are hearing the sound of my voice, after tonight's encounter, no power will hold you. 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 Somebody say, no power. Somebody said no witches. Somebody said no wizard. Somebody said no demon. Somebody said no forces will hold me. Shall hold me. Say I must stop it all. Say I must stop it all. Say I must stop it all.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I enter into prayer. Is it rain? God is not looking for weak people. God is looking for people that are strong. In Ezekiel 37, verse 1, the Bible says, he told Ezekiel, son of man, can this bone God is saying, I should tell you, do not be moved by the wind of failure. Be moved by the word of God. The wind of failure is always there. The Bible says when Moses was caught at a point, on his front, it was the Red Sea. On his back, the Egyptians. The Bible says God spoke to him. What is on your hand? Your face can command a miracle. Your mouth as you pray can command a miracle. The Bible says he told Abraham in Genesis chapter 13 verse 15. He said, as far as you can see, You can be limited by space. You can be limited by your mental faculty. You can be limited by family history. You can be limited by those things you refuse to see. But the Lord said, Abraham, he said, as far as you can see. So prayer is a school. Until you register, it's like a tuition fee. You are in the presence of God this morning. It's a tuition fee. And you don't stop. The Bible says, the book of Psalms says, thy word has hidden my heart, that I may not sin against thee. There are forces in our family. There are forces in your neighborhood, in your place of assignment where you work. There are forces. Those are when I was coming up as a young man, I used to think maybe if you are fair, so Satan does not come close. As a man, if you are handsome, Satan can't come close to handsome men because they are handsome. But then I referred myself in the Bible. Saul was a handsome man. But what happened to Saul? God spat him out of his mouth. Those that used to think, if you are so rich, there were no problem. But statistics have discovered many, many rich men has hidden secret. So everyone coming, we are coming from somewhere. We are coming from a particular family. No matter who you are, your family is not free. Wherever you're coming from, you're not free. You could be the only child of God there, a born-again Christian. But what about your sister? Is she born again? What about your uncle? Is he born again? What about your auntie? Is he born again? The Bible says in Matthew chapter 17, verse 21, he said, howbeit is this kind? Thus not out unless through fasting and prayer. In Isaiah chapter 19, verse 2, he said, I will set the Egyptians against themselves.